As we embark on our exploration of the vast ocean, let's consider how we can gather information about a place that is often deep, dark, and dangerous. Let's find out how ocean observatories let us visit this mysterious place.
Well, Ocean Networks Canada is a unique facility in the world. And it's unique because it is a place where we can measure the changes in the ocean 24/7 in the Northeast Pacific and what's called here the Salish Sea.
Ocean Networks Canada operates Neptune and Venus, two cabled ocean observatories off the west coast of British Columbia. The observatories supply power and internet connectivity to a broad suite of subsea instruments from the coast to the deep sea. They support research on complex ocean and earth processes in ways not previously possible.
So it's very different from other kind of observatories. It's not one instrument at one time in one place in the ocean. It's persistent in a place where then the ocean changes over these instruments. And we have instruments in the water column, on the seafloor, and beneath the seafloor to really understand that incredibly connected system.
These underwater labs are bringing us huge volumes of data. What are researchers doing with all this information?
Oh, well, Ocean Networks Canada has a pretty broad range of science disciplines that are working on data and instruments from both Neptune Canada and Venus. And those are related to everything from earthquakes to tsunamis to ecosystems. We're also studying marine mammals. We're studying sound in the ocean. We're studying wave energy and how that impacts things like release of gas hydrates on the seafloor. It is one of the most diverse facilities of its kind, studying almost every aspect of the oceans and the seafloor beneath.
We were not only here to support excellent science, but we were also here to realize benefits for Canada. It relates to how it helps to stimulate commercial opportunity and how the public can better understand what we're doing and how the science can inform their knowledge of the ocean.
The role of the centre is to help grow the ocean technology sector in Canada. And we do that through mechanisms like the technology demonstration facility, where we help develop new sensor technologies. And also we help develop new ocean observing systems, both within Canada and internationally.
One of the major accomplishments, obviously, has been to build the system. There were many doubters, quite frankly, who said this can't be done. The fact that we've done it, the fact that we've been operating now successfully with high reliability of most of those systems for the last several years is a testimony, obviously, to what has been accomplished.
We're so excited about the accomplishments of Ocean Networks Canada, but we have aspirations to see it grow even further. Already the world is coming to the University of Victoria and Ocean Networks Canada to understand how observatories operate. And we know that people are interested in putting these observatories in virtually everywhere in the world.
Today we had a chance to learn about ocean observatories. Thanks to the team at Ocean Networks Canada, and thanks to you for being part of our ongoing explorations here at Ocean Alive.